Dear students, how is going on for you all? I hope everything is going on well for you. Okay, so without wasting our time, we'll go for our further topic. Okay, so welcome back to our lesson, that is our environment. So various topic related to the lesson, our environment, we have tried to cover. That is the concept of environment, the components of the environment, then types of the waste, and how these biotic and abiotic components are depend on each other, as well as the concept of the ecosystem, two types of ecosystem, artificial, and how these are depend on each other, how every organism is depend on each other in an ecosystem, for the harmonious relationship among plants and animals. Okay, so this all the topics we have tried to cover into the lesson. Now we'll go to a very important topic from this lesson, that is food chain and the food web. So students, we all are knowing that in ecosystem, in our ecosystem, in our environment, there is an interaction between biotic components and abiotic components. For what? This interaction is for what? This interaction is for flow of energy and for the matter. This is the biomass, the amount of matter present in the body, that is called as a biomass. So, in an ecosystem, there is an interaction between biotic components and abiotic components for what? Flow of energy and for the matter or biomass. Okay. So, there are two ways for the flow of energy. Okay. There are two processes or two ways into the environment through which such kind of flow of energy and the matter is taking place. Flow of energy and the flow of biomass is taking place by two ways into the environment. What are those ways? That are food chain and food web. So first, we will have a look on food chain. What is meant by food chain?
Terrestrial food chain terrestrial and aquatic. Okay, and this terrestrial also divided into two, that is forest and grassland. Okay, this terrestrial means there are two types of oxygen. It's terrestrial, means which takes place on the land, and aquatic means in the water. So terrestrial oxygen is also divided into two, that is first is forest and another is grassland. Okay, so here we are going to talk about every oxygen. So first we will talk about forest oxygen. See, suppose these are the plants into the forest. Various plants are present in the forest, and on this oxygen organism into the food chain is always written into the block. Okay, it is always written into the block. It is the method. It's a process to write always. So plants. Then second is plants are eaten by rabbit. Say plants are eaten by rabbit. This rabbit is eaten by fox, right? And this fox is eaten by lion. For rabbit, plant is a food. Okay, so it is called as a food. This is called as a feeder. On plants, the rabbit is dependent, right? So this is feeder. Okay, but for the fox, rabbit is the food, while fox is the feeder. Okay, and for the lion, fox is the food and lion is the feeder. Okay, so the series or sequence of organism in an ecosystem depend on one another for the food. Such series of organism is called as a food chain. So this is the example of a forest food chain. So various kinds of food chains are there. It's not like that always plants will be eaten by rabbit. Various organisms are there into the plant, such as goat is there, cow is there, as well as deer are there, zebra is there. Various organisms are there, and these are eaten by the carnivores. We are going. These all organisms are herbivores, and these are eaten by the carnivores. Carnivores are also primary, secondary, and tertiary. So this is eaten by the carnivores, and carnivores' body is decomposed by decomposers. In earlier class, I had explained you the function of the decomposers. So here, what happens? The series of an organism which depend on one another for the food. That is called as a food chain. So this is the example of a food chain. Now this example I will write like this to explain you the further concept of the food chain, so that don't have to draw. So these are plants. Okay, these are plants. Plants are eaten by rabbit. Okay, rabbit is eaten by, let's say, fox, and fox is eaten by plant. This is a food chain. Then next, all these plants will be down because plants are the food sources, right? Plants will be eaten by deer. Deer will be eaten by jackal. Jackal will be eaten by tiger. Okay, so this is food chain. Now we will talk about grassland. At the grassland, there is a grass. Because this is the grassland, this is grass. Grass may be eaten by grasshopper. This grasshopper will be eaten by frog. Frog will be eaten by snake. Snake will be eaten by hawk, one kind of bird. Okay, students. So these are examples of the forest food chain. This is the example of a grassland food chain. Okay, there is one example of a aquatic food chain. Aquatic food chain. What happens? Phytoplanktons. Phytoplanktons means what? The plants which are present into the aquatic bodies, such as rivers, oceans, and seas. That is called as a phytoplanktons. So phytoplanktons are performing the role of a plant. Phytoplanktons are eaten by zooplanktons, find and can make food for you. And small fishes are eaten by the large fishes such as shark and all. Okay, large fishes. So this is one kind of food chain which is taking place into the aquatic ecosystem. Okay, or this is part of the aquatic food chain. Okay, students. So here what happens? This is the concept of the food chain, and this is the these are the examples of the food chain. But students, plants, it is not necessary that plants will always be eaten by rabbit and rabbit will be eaten by always fox. It is not possible. Rabbit can also be eaten by jackal, and jackal can also be eaten by lion. Here, plants can be eaten by deer also, and this deer can be eaten by fox also. Fox can be eaten by tiger also. Understood, students? So here, what happens? This is the network of the food chain. Okay, in our ecosystem, various food chains are arranged in the form of network. Always, it is not necessary that particular animal will be eaten by the particular other animal. Okay, so food can be taken, means food can be eaten by everyone. Understood? Anyone which is at the top carnivore, lion, tiger, leopard, these are at the top of the carnivore. So these can be used for the food. Anyone, they can use zebra. Zebra also can be eaten by them. Deer can be eaten by them, goat can be eaten by them, cow can be eaten by them, because these are herbivores. So various organisms can be eaten by the various other organisms. So this is called as the interlinking of the food chain. Interlinking, this is one kind of interlinking. So interlinking of this food chain or the network of various food chain is called as a food web. Do you get, students? The concept of food chain is clear for you. The network of various food chain, interlinking of various food chain is called as a food web. Okay, so network of various food chain is called as food web. Okay, students. So there are two ways into our environment which are responsible for the flow of energy and the biomass. This is covered. Now I will go ahead for the trophic level. Trophic level is also very important. Students, you have to write always the organism into the food chain, into the block form. And if you want to show the horizontal food chain, then you have to point it in a horizontal form like this. You have to. Okay, in the form of this, means horizontal row you have to show. Okay, mostly you don't have to write. As I wanted to again explain you food web, so that I have written this as a in a vertical form. But mostly the food chain will be written into the horizontal form. Okay, which will be in the block letter, and the arrow is pointing in a horizontal direction. So write this. The food chain and the food web is clear for you, I hope. Now we will go for the further topic. That is trophic layer. What is meant by trophic layer? Organisms into the food chain. Every organism into the food chain is called as a trophic layer. Understood? So suppose plants. Plants are eaten by rabbit. Rabbits are eaten by, say, fox. Okay. So every level in a food chain is called as a trophic level. Every level, this is first level, this is second level, this is third level, there will be fourth level. Okay, so food chain, mainly the food chain is formed not more than five trophic level. Food chain is always formed from 3 to 5 trophic level. Understood? Means in the food chain only 5 organisms will be included, not more than 5 organisms. Understood? 3 to 5 organisms are involved in every food chain. Okay, so trophic level means what? The organisms into the food chain is called as a trophic layer. Do you get, students? So trophic level concept is clear. Now we will go for the food pyramid. The food pyramid is also called as a the triangle of a trophic level. called as a this trophic levels are always written into the triangle form, or it is also called as a food pyramid. You are knowing food pyramid is flat at the down, and as it is going up, it is becoming slender, it's pointed shape. So at the bottom there are plants. In every trophic level, I will show you through this trophic level. I will explain you more various things. Here plants are present. These plants may also say producers. Okay, plants may be eaten by herbivores. Okay, these are producers and remaining these all are consumers. Okay, these herbivores are eaten by primary carnivores. Primary carnivores are eaten by secondary carnivores. Secondary carnivores are eaten by tertiary carnivores. Okay, with the example I will explain you. See, suppose this is our food chain, and in this food chain down there are plants. Plants are eaten by grasshopper. Grasshopper are eaten by frog. Frogs are eaten by snakes. And snakes are eaten by hawk or eagle. Okay, so here in this trophic level, plants are what? Plants are producers. Plants are producers. Okay, then grasshoppers are what? Herbivores. Grasshoppers are herbivores. The herbivores are eaten by primary carnivore, because this is the frog which is eating first time flesh. Flesh eating organisms are called carnivores. So frog is the first organism in this trophic level who is going to eat the flesh. So this frog is called as a primary carnivore. Okay. After it, snakes. Snake is second time eating the flesh in this trophic level. So this is called as a secondary consumer or secondary carnivore. Then hawk. After snakes, there is a hawk. Snake will be eaten by the hawk. So it is called as a tertiary carnivore. So this is the common idea of the trophic level. The trophic level is designed like this. Now in this trophic level, there are three major events taking place. These three events are very, very important, students, because based on these various kinds of questions are asked. I think food chain and food web is covered for you. Now what is meant by trophic level is also covered for you. Every organism which is present into the food chain, that is called as a trophic level. And we are talking about this grassland ecosystem. In the grassland ecosystem, how many trophic levels are there? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. If you will take our forest ecosystem, there will be 4 trophic levels. Okay, if you will talk about aquatic ecosystem or aquatic food chain, then there will be 4 trophic levels. So here, this is the grassland ecosystem. So in a grassland ecosystem, the trophic levels are not more than 5. Always these are 3 to 5. Okay. So now what are the major events taking place in this trophic level? What are those? First is what? The first major event which is taking place in the trophic level, the flow of energy is unidirectional. The flow of energy is unidirectional. Unidirectional means what, student? Means the energy flow is only in a one direction, like this. Only in one direction, means from top, from bottom to the top. The flow of energy is unidirectional. Second is 10% law. 10% law. And third is biomagnification. Or also it is said to be biological magnification. Biological magnification. So these are the three major events taking place into the trophic level. So now we will explain one by one. Okay. Now see, students, called as a food pyramid. At the base of it, there are producers, then herbivores, and so on, carnivores. As we know, producers means plants, right? Producers means plants. These plants are preparing food with the help of the abiotic compounds. With the help of the abiotic components. What are the abiotic components is used by the plants to prepare their food? Soil, water, CO2, and what is it? Sunlight. Okay, so plants are preparing their food with the help of the abiotic components called as a soil, water, CO2 and sunlight. Here, the water and CO2 can also be said to be inorganic component. Inorganic simple component. Inorganic simple components. What is those? CO2 and H2. Because CO2 and H2 is a simple. Now, they have to take it in a simpler form and they have to convert it. Plants have to convert them into the complex organic form. So, they are taking this from the environment into the inorganic form, that is carbon dioxide and water, okay? And preparing the food with the help of the photosynthesis. But obviously, yes, plants contain chlorophyll and chlorophyll is also playing a major role here. But this is not the part. Chlorophyll, I am not going to teach you over here. I am going to teach you the events in the trophic level. So, I neglected here chlorophyll. But chlorophyll is also a major factor for the process of the photosynthesis. Keep in mind, don't neglect. Chlorophyll is also present, soil in water, CO2, inorganic component like CO2 and H2O is present, as well as the very important component that is sunlight. Without it, the plants cannot prepare the food. So, sunlight is used by the plants to prepare the food, okay? So, sunlight is also called solar energy, okay? So, this solar energy is directly utilized by the plants to convert it into the chemical energy. So, solar energy is converted into chemical energy. Okay, solar energy is converted. Photosynthesis is one kind of chemical process. So, solar energy is converted into chemical energy, means what plants are using this solar energy directly to prepare their own food. Okay, whenever these plants are eaten by herbivores, so herbivores are not directly dependent on the solar energy. Right? Plants have already made the food with the help of the solar energy, and that energy will be eaten by the herbivores. So herbivores and carnivores and so on are not directly dependent on the solar energy. So solar energy is directly used by the plants, while other trophic levels are the indirect source of the solar energy. So the question can be asked, how can you say that the other their plants are present. Then adios. Then primary. Carnivores. See, frequently I am running and writing it so that you can recite right now. No need to do the separate practice for it. Okay? Because many a times they are asking directly ki what is trophic level or draw it. Okay? So that you are getting practice. As I am writing frequently, you are also getting practice for it. Primary, then secondary carnivore. Then tertiary. Okay, about tertiary carnivore, there are many components. Okay, so what happens here, students? Plants are preparing food in the help of the sunlight. Okay, suppose these are the plants. These are the plants. Plants are using the solar energy. So only 1%. See here, students, very important. This question may ask you for MCQs or for your fill in the blanks type question. Only 1% of the solar energy is utilized by the plant for the process of the photosynthesis. 99% of the solar energy is going back to the environment. It's very important. Only 1% of energy is used by the plants for the process of photosynthesis. Remaining all energy is absorbed by the atmosphere. Understood? Means 1% of energy is falling on the leaves of the plants and preparing the own food. Okay, after plants have prepared now the food, then herbivores are going to eat to the plants or producers. So now herbivores will only use 10% of energy from the plants. 90% energy, where it would go? It would be lost. Okay, 10% of energy for what the herbivores will use? 10% of energy can be used for the metabolic activities. Metabolic activities such as respiration process, such as digestion process, metabolic activities. Okay, then second for respiration for physical work. Plant has to perform physical work also while surviving in a regular life. Physical work as well as for the reproduction too. For the growth, simply. So 10% of energy plants, from the plants whatever the energy would be, out of that only 10% of energy this herbivores will use for what? Metabolic activities such as digestion and all, for respiration, for physical work, for reproduction and for growth. Then what about the 90% of energy? 90% of energy will get lost in the environment in the form of heat. Understood? In the form of heat, 90% of energy will be released back. It will lose into the environment. Again, from the herbivores, primary consumers will also only 10% of energy for the same purpose. And 90% of energy will get lose into the environment into the form of heat. Again, the same process. The secondary, tertiary consumers, even the decomposers, will also use only 10% of energy from the previous trophic level, and 90% of energy will be released into the environment in the form of heat. So there will be a lot amount of heat will be present into the environment. That is called as a community heat, because from every trophic level the heat will release at every trophic level, and that heat is called as a community heat. Okay? Why only 10% of energy is utilized by the plants? So say here I would like to give a simple example. So through examples it will be more easy for you to understand. Suppose plants are preparing. Plants have 10,000 joule of energy. Okay? So out of that 10% means 1,000 joule of energy will get utilized by herbivores. So again 10% means 100 joule of energy will get utilized by the primary consumers. Then secondary consumers will use only 10 joule of energy. Right? And tertiary consumer will get only 1 joule of energy. And decomposers will 10% down. 10% of energy is only utilized for some activities, and 90% of energy is used into the environment into the form of heat, and that is called as a 10% down. So if you will have a look on it, you can see the shape of this like a triangle. Means at the bottom there are various organisms, means biomass, the matter which is present into the organism is more at the bottom level. As we will go high, this biomass is getting reduced. Why it is getting reduced? Because of this, because here. So question in the exam can be asked at in the trophic level, at the top of the trophic level, why there are very less organisms are present, and at the bottom why plants are poor. Okay, means why the shape is like a triangle, that down it is more organisms, while as we go higher, why the organisms are getting reduced. So this is the reason for it, that is 10% now, only 10% of energy is used, other is used into the environment, into the form of heat. And as we go higher, the energy is reduced. So very less amount of energy is present for the top carnivores, and so that the number of carnivores are less into the environment as compared to the producers, such as plants. Okay, so these are the, this is the second event which is taking place into the trophic level. Now we will go for the third event, that is called as a biological magnification or biomagnification. See students, see, suppose these are the plants or the crops, we can say crops also. And you are knowing the plants have the roots. Okay, so see here students, as in olden days we were completely depend on the organic food. Okay, means we were completely depend on the manures. Whatever the manures we were giving to the plants, that manures were used by the plants to prepare the food. Okay, and so that we were not suffering from hazardous diseases. But nowadays the diseases are rapidly increasing. Why this is increasing? This is the reason, as we are now trying to provide more and more amount of fertilizers to the plants. Why we use fertilizers? Because fertilizers are nutrient specific. Specific kind of nutrients are present into the fertilizers. NPK is a very good example for it. And so that we are sprinkling them at the particular time into the soil. And soil is absorbing those fertilizers along with what? Mineral and water. Along with water and mineral, the roots are absorbing these fertilizers. Okay, means excess amount of food can be prepared. A large, or we can increase the yield of the crop with the help of the fertilizers. Actually, this is not the fault of the farmers even, because farmers has to feed many people, right? Many people now, as our population is over increasing, the demand for the food is also increasing. So small amount of food or the food which is present only on the manure cannot fulfill the demand of the this overpopulation. And so that to feed everyone, the farmers are using this fertilizers. So fertilizers are the which increase the fertility of the soil, and so that the food can be prepared in the more amount. So this is the main role of the fertilizers. And one more thing related to the fertilizers are non-biodegradable. Means fertilizers cannot be biodegradable, and non-biodegradable concept is clear for you. So these are non-biodegradable. These cannot be decomposed or decay. Non-biodegradable, it remains. Okay. So these are the waters and the minerals absorb fertilizers along with its root. These are getting absorbed. After it, pesticides, insecticides, rodenticides, okay, fungicides also are sprinkling on the crops for the protection, right? So these pesticides, insecticides, rodenticides, fungicides, whatever, all are also entering into the plant body, and these are also non-biodegradable. So what happens? Unknowingly, these all kind of non-biodegradable wash the vegetables and the fruits and vegetables properly. But by washing, this fertilizers cannot be go from our food chain. Now it has already entered in our food chain. So some kind of fertilizers are used along with water and mineral by the plant, and pesticides and insecticides are also eaten. Now what will happen? This will be eaten by herbivores, and herbivores will be eaten by carnivores. Understood? So unknowingly, this all fertilizers are now entered into the food chain, and now this is accumulated into the food chain. But accumulation, in accumulation, this is one interesting thing to know that in trophic level we have seen a 10% law that energy, as we go up, the energy is reduced. But these fertilizers are magnifying. Whenever these are means plants are used by herbivores, so herbivores will be eaten by carnivores. So in carnivores body, the fertilizers, this all fertilizers, non-body product fertilizers will be in the excess amount. Okay, so this flow, fertilizers flow is gone increasing. Understood? And at the top of this food chain, we have a more amount of this fertilizers. Understood? That is called as a biological magnification. But see students, these fertilizers are not only used by specific plants. Some excess amount of fertilizers will go into the soil, and as there will be heavy rain at that time, what happens along with the soil, this will be flow into the water bodies, surface water bodies such as river, oceans and the seas. It will reach to this part, and what will happen, there are also some plant, this aquatic ecosystem will have a aquatic plants. So what will happen, these fertilizers will be used by this aquatic aquatic plants also. Aquatic ecosystem, in aquatic ecosystem there are aquatic plants, and aquatic plants will utilize this fertilizers, and slowly slowly what will happen, they will get fertilizers, so they will grow rapidly. As they will grow rapidly, there will be whole surface of this water bodies will get covered. That is called as the algal bloom. You have learned this in class 8, algal bloom. So this is covered by all fertilizers will be used by the aquatic plants, and so that the covering of all the water will be completely, it will be placed. Okay, and so that what will happen, the aquatic animals will not get the enough oxygen for the aquatic animals, because we are knowing the oxygen is dissolved in a less amount. And in that case, we have covered this aquatic plants are covered with this, because the rapid growth of the plants, it is covered. And so that what will happen, they will get very less amount of oxygen, and they may die in future, they may die. So that that position or that procedure is called as a algal bloom. That we are not going to study, and you also don't have to write, but I just gave you acquisition of it, which you have already learned in class 8. So what happens, these fertilizers are reaching into the aquatic ecosystem also. These are reaching into the aquatic ecosystem also, because these are eaten, plants will grow, then plants will be eaten by zooplanktons, zooplanktons will be eaten by small fishes, small fishes will be eaten by the large fishes. And we are at the top of it, because we are using the human beings. Human beings is the omnivores. We are going, they are used plants, they are used some herbivores, okay, as well as we are fish eating, means we are using fishes also. Small and large fish we are using, and already the accumulation of this fertilizer, non-body product fertilizer, in these plants and herbivores and fish is more. And so our body will have a more excess amount of all these fertilizers. And so that nowadays we are suffering from the diseases such as cancer. We can see the growth of carcinogenic cell is growing very rapidly. The growth is very rapid of the carcinogenic cell. Or every family, we can see one or two members are now suffering from this cancer. Even in other human body is grown. So these are the three major events taking place into the trophic level. That is, first, the flow of energy is unidirectional. Second is 10% law, only 10% of energy is used, and 90% is released into the atmosphere in the form of heat. That is called as a community heat. And the third is biological magnification. gets in.